Are you finding this section easy? तुम कहाँ गए थे इतने दिन? बुलबुल? अच्छा, मुझे लगा बुलबुल को रिसीव करने गए थे. सो हैज द पोल्यूशन इंक्रीज्ड आउटसाइड टुडे? टू थ्री इसमें स्टार्टिंग रीजनल ग्रोथ एंड प्लानिंग इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंस बिकॉज द इवन दो द रिसोर्सेज आर नॉट इक्वली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड द ग्रोथ एंड डेवलपमेंट हैज टू बी इक्वली डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड एंड हाउ टू यूज दिस ग्रोथ एंड डेवलपमेंट इज द एसेंस ऑफ इकोनॉमिक ज्योग्राफी रीजनल डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन एंड प्लानिंग. यू कैन यूज इवन दिस इंट्रोडक्शन फाइन टू गिव दिस. देर इज अ थियरी विच डील्स अबाउट इट, दैट इज द ग्रोथ पोल एंड ग्रोथ सेंटर थियरी. फाइन, फिर उसके बाद थियरी द कंसेप्ट वॉज The concept of the economic theory was given by Perox, whose geographical application was by Bedwille. So according to him, the development of any region is based on two parameters, that is the region jahan pe propulsive firm is located. This propulsive firm will act as an center for industrial growth because it will result into formation of ancillary industries, etc. Initially there will be the backwash effect. That is, there will be concentration of the growth around the region, which is known as the growth pole. But over the period of time, as the growth pole develops, the industries will like to spread, and this will result into the secondary growth centers. This is what is this theory. Fine. Is this theory successful or not? We are going to do today. That is the relevance, application, and the relevance of the growth center or growth pole in today's India. So. क्वेश्चन अगर आता है इन इंडिया, यू हैव टू लुक एट टू एंगल्स, दैट इज द ग्रोथ पोल एंड ग्रोथ सेंटर ऑफ सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट विथ विथ पीएसयूज एज द प्रपल्सिव फर्म. पीएसयूज एज द प्रपल्सिव फर्म, फाइन. एंड रिसेंट अगर पूछा तो मेंशन एसईजेड, बट अगर आता है क्वेश्चन रेलिवेंस ऑफ ग्रोथ पोल एंड ग्रोथ सेंटर इन इंडिया एंड इफ यू राइट विथ एसईजेड, That is half an answer because सबसे पहले आपको लिखना पड़ेगा regarding भले ही जमशेदपुर and this thing. That is the most important. किसने किया था? Government of India ने. Why multinational companies were not there? Why there were only the PSUs? Because the PSUs का एक extra, see, remember, private sector का orientation is profit. Fine? Government का orientation is welfare. Understanding? PSUs which are companies owned by government, उनका orientation is both profit as well as welfare. उनका orientation is not just profit maximization. That will be the difference between Shell या Castrol and ONGC. ONGC has some responsibility towards the citizens of India. Understanding? And इसलिए PSU-led growth model was taken in the central India. Was it successful? No. क्यों? Trickle down effect did not occur. Why? Trickle down effect did not occur, and as the trickle down effect, why it did not occur? Because this acted as the growth engines for Mumbai industrial region and Kolkata industrial region. Second growth pole, which was done with the help of PSUs, was Hyderabad. The city of Hyderabad is also an example of a growth pole. Remembering, understanding, Hyderabad ko design kiya gaya tha as a growth pole. For the interior parts, this part of India, Hyderabad was designed so that this part of India becomes progressive. Jo bhi central India ka drought prone region hai, as well as Andhra, etc. Failure or success? Failure. Hyderabad is the only city which is successful in Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. But Hyderabad could not have an effect like Chennai. और लाइक मुंबई की उसने बाकी के रीजन्स को फेल किया. सी, चेन्नई, बैंगलोर, मैसूर, ऊटी इंडस्ट्रियल रीजन, फाइन. मुंबई, पुणे, नासिक इंडस्ट्रियल रीजन, दिल्ली, जयपुर इंडस्ट्रियल रीजन, दिल्ली, जयपुर, गुड़गांव इंडस्ट्रियल रीजन, कोलकाता, हुगली इंडस्ट्रियल रीजन, बट हैदराबाद? नो, सिर्फ हैदराबाद. अंडरस्टैंडिंग? थर्ड एग्जाम्पल ऑफ अ ग्रोथ पोल. देखो, वी हैव We were the people who were most impressed by the growth poll, because growth poll was impressed by Harrod and Domer. You already know who is Harrod and Domer, fine? Human geographers are Harrod and Domer, and you already study the first 5-year plan. First or second Harrod Domer growth model. Second 5-year plan is Harrod Domer growth model. So, wo unsuccessful hua. The third growth poll in India is Vishakhapatnam. It was also unsuccessful. Fine, port-led growth model, Vishakhapatnam. Kyunki porting ki basic facilities nahi thi tab Eastern India mein. But today, Vishakhapatnam is going to be successful. Vishakhapatnam ka aaj alag story hai. Not because of growth pole or growth center, but because of market economics. So, you have to understand growth pole and growth center is the planned development which generally is not successful, because like quantitative theories, ye quantification ka hi part hai, it does not take into account culture, values, norms. Matlab, it did not take into account the tribal development, skill development of tribes in Chhattisgarh, Bhilai region, Jharkhand region. Understanding why quantitative revolution is failing, because till the time you don't make the tribals understand what you mean by growth, they will take anything that you do as an intrusion. They don't want to change from their old lifestyle. They will think as if aap aa rahe ho to take their land and to intrude their land. Fine? Vishakhapatnam did not become successful, or Hyderabad did not become successful, because there were no focus on developing the other centers. So, whether the growth poll will be successful or whether the market economics will be successful, it is always the market economics that will be successful. What do you mean by market economics? The market will look for the best conditions. If best conditions are present at the growth poll, it will be successful. If the best conditions are not present at the growth poll, it will be failure. Kahan pe growth poll successful hai? No need of writing this. So, sabse pehle, one of the biggest junction and airport was developed. Uske baad, this became an agricultural center, one of the largest agro-processing industries in the world. Excess money were given in the form of Pittsburgh, which became an iron and steel center and the shipbuilding center. Uske baad, Detroit. उसके बाद एक्रॉन. पिट्सबर्ग का सक्सेस रिजल्टेड इनटू ऑटोमोबाइल इंडस्ट्री कमिंग इन द डेट्रॉइट. डेट्रॉइट का सक्सेस रिजल्टेड इनटू द रबर इंडस्ट्री कमिंग इनटू एक्रॉन. टायर का इंडस्ट्री कमिंग इनटू एक्रॉन. मिशेलिन ग्रुप ऑफ टायर्स या कोई भी ग्रुप ऑफ टायर्स कमिंग इनटू एक्रॉन. वहां से इट रिजल्टेड इनटू financial capital coming into New York, administrative capital, Washington, and therefore this Toronto, fine, and thus this, fir Toronto mein aaya aviation industry, automobile industry, agro-processing industry, iron and steel industry, then rubber industry, financial capitals. And this is what is the perfect example of growth pole and trickling down effect. Kisse shuru kiya? Agriculture se. Hum kisse shuru karte hai? Industrialization se. Is the strength of USA in agriculture? No. Still, it goes through the basics. That is, agriculture should first dominate, and then if the agriculture is dominating, then ye regions are successful. This region ka excess money comes and it is invested here. This region ka excess money comes, it is then invested here. Hum shuru karte hai isse, neglecting this part. So excess money never comes. Understanding? Excess finance never comes. excess capital never comes. Kitne din tak government will keep on pumping the money? One day government will have to look at uska deficits. And thus, most of the PSUs in India therefore fail. Understanding? So this is what is the growth pole and growth center ka relevance in today's time. So, first relevance. Leftist approach. Leftist approach has led to the failure of growth pole and growth center. Aisa hai. And which has resulted into Naxalite approach. Leftist approach or Naxalite? You are trying to link leftist with Naxalite. Nahi. Leftist approach tha. इसलिए ग्रोथ पुल फेल हो गया. मार्केट इकोनॉमिक्स को ज़्यादा इंपॉर्टेंस नहीं दिया. ग्रोथ पुल फेल हो गया तो लोग रिवोल्टेड एंड देयरफॉर तिरुपति टू पशुपति इज द नक्सलाइट बेल्ट ऑफ इंडिया. नक्सलाइट बेल्ट रेड कॉरिडोर क्या है? तिरुपति इन आंध्रा टू पशुपति इन नेपाल इज द नक्सलाइट कॉरिडोर ऑफ इंडिया. दैट्स व्हाई इट इज फेलिंग अगेन. नहीं नहीं, कल्चर एंड ट्रेडिशन इंडिया का सबसे कम रिजिड है, सबसे कम रिजिड है. ट्राइबल इसलिए चेंज नहीं होना चाहते बिकॉज उनको कोई सॉल्यूशन मिलता नहीं है, बट सबसे कम रिजिड है इंडियन कल्चर. याद रखना, इंडियन कल्चर इसलिए सर्वाइव हो रहा है बिकॉज इट इज लीस्ट रिजिड. होमोजेनिटी. The most important thing in all the other worlds is homogeneous. India ka one of the biggest thing is non-homogeneity, cultural differences. USSR was homogeneous. Two religions, Islam on the borders and Christianity in the inside. No caste, right? Secondly, no political discourse because it was centralized. Understanding? And USSR ka biggest strength lies in engineering. It was technology at technologically much much superior than India. Uska biggest strength lies in engineering. What did C. Uday Bhaskar told that day? He said Chinese Republic Day ke parade mein, whatever they are, everything is made in China. It was the biggest thing. And when we call Indians, when we show in the Republic Day, we call Putin. So Putin kya kehta hoga? Why you are showing me this? Ye sab hamara hi hai. Right? Sukhoi goes, he knows. Tank comes, he knows. Submarine comes, he knows. Understanding? Obama, you are calling to the Republic Day parade. What he'll say? Whom you are showing? If you look at the jokes, Putin is sitting on the Republic Day parade and Brahmos comes, he must be thinking what he are to do. Then Sukhoi comes, then Rafale comes, then MiG comes. Anything which is developed in India, then tank comes, then Pinaka missile system comes, then DRDO comes, fine, Ministry of Steel comes. Everything to Russia ka help hai. Submarine, Russian help. We should be calling Nepal, Bhutan, Africa. You see how much is our strength. ASEAN countries. So, means that is the problem. And see, today we will be doing very interesting theory, that is the heartland, rimland concept. Many things will be clear uske baad. Why India is not a major global player except in the service sector, and except because India's biggest strength is also its biggest weakness. India's biggest weakness is population, but us population ko direction de do, that is going to be the India's biggest strength. Jisko hum kehte hai demographic dividend. Fine. Next, that is the application to India, application to India, case study one. The growth pole and the growth center promised to remove inter-regional disparities. Through accelerated economic growth resulting from propulsive form. And therefore, large public sector projects where established in India at centers such as Bokaro, Rourkela, Durgapur and Bhilai, etc. Bhilai, etc. Why I chose that four names? Because prelims ke liye aapko pata hona chahiye ye four names. These are iron and steel plants which came up in second 5-year plan. Tell me the countries which helped us. UK. Who helped Durgapur plant? Who helped Rourkela plant? UK or France or Germany or US? Who helped Bokaro plant? देखो इसका एक बहुत सिंपल ये है, जो बी से है दे वेर नॉट हेल्प बाय ग्रेट ब्रिटेन, राइट? ग्रेट ब्रिटेन हेल्प्ड, यू जस्ट रिमेंबर द शॉर्टकट DU, दिल्ली यूनिवर्सिटी. Right? DU. R से was not helped by Russia. Understanding? And therefore, एक ही बचता है, जर्मनी. It's very, just remember DU, दिल्ली यूनिवर्सिटी. And then can I continue? The propulsive firm included steel plants, fertilizers, heavy electricals, heavy electricals. With the focus that they will help in development of the hinterlands. With the focus that they will help in development of the hinterlands. Hinterlands. Removing the problems of Bimaru regions or Bimaru states. These are economic terms. Bimaru states. What are Bimaru states? States are known as Bimaru states, used to be known as, fine, economic terms mein. Obviously isme Rajasthan was not there. Remember MP Chhattisgarh, UP Uttarakhand, Bihar Jharkhand. So Bimaru mein hi aata tha wo. These are the four states which are known as the Bimaru states. But it did not result into, it did not result into trickle down effect. It did not result into trickle down effect. Because one, these industries had linkages with the outside regions, Example, the fertilizer industry in this region was linked to agriculture regions of Punjab, or cotton growing regions of Maharashtra. Understanding means what I said, ploughing back of profits ho nahi raha tha is region mein. You should have ploughed back the profits, but yahan ka industrial development is happening, is helping whom? This region or cotton growing regions of this. So rather than developing the industries in this region, textile industry started coming here. Agriculture started coming here. So Ludhiana, Amritsar started becoming hosiery and textile centers, rather than a region becoming more and more important for industrial activity. Second, the inputs required for industrial development, inputs required for industrial development were imported from outside the states. उसने ये तो नहीं कहा था कि इंपोर्ट्स बाहर से लेके आओ. इंपोर्टेड फ्रॉम आउटसाइड द स्टेट्स. उसने कहा था दैट रीजन शुड बी सेल्फ सफिशिएंट. हमने इंपोर्ट सारा बाहर से लेके आए और मेनी टाइम्स फ्रॉम आउटसाइड द कंट्री. अंडरस्टैंडिंग इट. सो दिस रीजन वॉज नॉट मेड सेल्फ सफिशिएंट. व्हाट आई हैव ड्रॉन इज मुंबई कोलकाता हावड़ा लाइन, फाइन, रेलवे लाइन. एंड सेकेंड है कोलकाता दिल्ली रेलवे लाइन. सो जो भी डेवलपमेंट ये यहां पे हो रहा है, इट इज नियर द रेलवे लाइन. डायरेक्टली इट इज सेंट टू मुंबई पोर्ट, कोलकाता पोर्ट, एक्सपोर्टेड. या रॉ मटेरियल्स आर ब्रॉट, इंपोर्टेड. कैपिटल इज ब्रॉट, एक्सपोर्टेड. मींस अंडरस्टैंडिंग, कैपिटल यहां का प्रॉफिट इज इन्वेस्टेड हियर. क्यों? एक्सेसिबिलिटी है. व्हाई गवर्नमेंट डेवलप दिस लाइन? दिस लाइन इज नॉट डेवलप बाय गवर्नमेंट. बोथ दिस लाइन्स आर डेवलप बाय ब्रिटिशर्स. Because they wanted this region to be supplier of raw materials. Understanding? So what we should have done is we should have stopped this line somehow. Getting it? But wo possible nahi tha. We could not have stopped this line. Understanding this? Ye to sirf example hai. NH7, longest national highway. So yahan se bhejo to the other centers. But then culture, then the human factor comes in. That is where behavioral geography comes in. This is how you will understand why I say you should link. Ye to quantitative revolution. Hum phir isme dalenge the behavioral aspects of the people were not focused. You cannot ignore the behavioral geography. People should have been given education, skills, and then they would have resulted into thinking. Kya the wahan pe? Tribals. Kaun hai aaj wahan pe? Tribals. Understanding? They are not understanding the repercussions. They are not understanding why it is being done. They are still tribals. They are caught in the vicious circle of poverty. You have to change the aspects to behavioral geography. You have to change the aspects to humanistic geography. And jahan ye dono fail ho gaye the, radicalist geography came in this region. Marxism. Understanding? Getting it? Ab to capital is not also going in that region. Today is a market economy. That time it was a controlled economy. If it could not be done that time, to during that time, ab to bhul hi jao us region. Now we are in the market economy. Now the capital will not go there. And if the capital goes there, POSCO, world's largest foreign direct investment in India, comes in the form of POSCO. POSCO aata hai, POSCO waits for 20 years. Ki do hame permission, do hame permission. POSCO ka permission is given, then environment minister becomes Jairam Ramesh. He removes the permission of POSCO, saying that Niyamgari Hills ka tribals should be given more importance. Fine? Jairam Ramesh. POSCO then decides ki India mein aana hi nahi hai. Understanding? POSCO, when it goes from India, then world's largest electronic manufacturer decides not to come to India. I am forgetting the name of the country, company, which makes mobile phones. Foxconn hai. Yes, ek hi Chennai mein. What was the plan? Plan was to have in each and every place in India. Chennai, Bangalore, Nagpur. चंडीगढ़ नोएडा वॉज द आइडिया ऑफ फॉक्सकॉन. पॉस्को चला जाता है, फॉक्सकॉन ऑल्सो डिसाइड्स कि नो मोर न्यू इन्वेस्टमेंट्स इन इंडिया, अदरवाइज इंडिया वुड हैव बिकम अ हार्डवेयर का हब. ऑल द फोन्स वुड हैव बीन मेड इन इंडिया. ये 5 साल पहले, अब तो मेड इन इंडिया ही होगा बिकॉज चाइना में दे आर गोइंग टू समथिंग एल्स. फाइन, सो द फॉक्सकॉन इज कमिंग टू इंडिया, बट दिस शुड हैव. Foxconn is not coming to India, means Vivo is coming to India and all these phones are being made in India. Vivo is manufactured in Noida. Assembling it, not manufacturing. India would have been a manufacturing superpower, fine. 2013, isliye to we call this as a crony capitalism. Us time ka jo problem hua tha India mein, UPA 2, jo tha. So, kisko diya jata hai ministry, environment ki, Prakash Javadekar ko. क्यों? अंडरस्टैंडिंग, कभी कभी पॉलिटिक्स एक एंगल से देखा करो. वाई प्रकाश जावड़ेकर बिकम्स एन एनवायरमेंट मिनिस्टर? सब क्लियरेंस दे देता है एक ही दिन में. फाइन, एनजीटी को बंद कर देता है एक दिन में, बट देन इट इज टू लेट. सो हिस्टोरिकल रॉन्ग्स अगर आपको करना है तो यू कैनॉट डू इट नाउ. यू कैनॉट से कि अब इस गवर्नमेंट का जो रॉन्ग है आई विल, द नेक्स्ट गवर्नमेंट विल डू इट. अपॉर्चुनिटी चली जाती है बिकॉज इट इज अ ग्लोबलाइज्ड वर्ल्ड. इट इज नो लॉन्गर 1980s, 1990s और 2000. इट इज ग्लोबलाइज्ड वर्ल्ड. एवरीथिंग इज कनेक्टेड बाय फाइबर ऑप्टिक्स एंड डिसीजन मेकिंग इट ऑल डिपेंड्स अपॉन स्पीड. व्हाई बॉम्बे इज द टॉप मोस्ट पोस्टिंग फॉर कस्टम्स JNPT? नॉट बिकॉज वहां पे इलीगल काम होते हैं, इट इज बिकॉज बिग कंटेनर्स कम. And containers, it is decided by the custom officer which container to be given early access. Agar custom officer ne container ko ek container ko ek din mein sign kiya, dusre container ko ek hafte mein sign kiya, to Sony ka TV will come early in the market and Samsung may come late in the market, though may have the same technology. Gaya? Understanding? Jo early mover advantage hai wo chala gaya. So just for signing, the money is given. इट इज़ नॉट की ड्रग्स बिग्स जो हिंदी मूवीज में दिखाते हैं पहले जैसा कि ड्रग्स वो सब ला रहे हैं. नो बडी इज डूइंग दैट. इट इज जस्ट फॉर साइनिंग कि इफ यू आर पोस्टेड इन JNPT फॉर 6 months यू हैव 2 or 3 फ्लैट्स इन मुंबई. फाइन, 2 and 3 फ्लैट्स इन मुंबई मतलब 6 to 7 crore का एक तीनों घर का. बट JNPT की पोस्टिंग भी नहीं मिलती सबको. यू डोंट रिक्वायर करप्ट ऑफिसर देयर, यू रिक्वायर करप्ट बट हाईली एफिशियंट ऑफिसर. वहां पे हॉनेस्ट ऑफिसर भी काम नहीं करेगा, हॉनेस्ट बट नॉट एफिशिएंट. सबसे खतरनाक कॉम्बिनेशन क्या होता है? हाईली करप्ट बट हाईली एफिशिएंट. फाइन, ही इज द मोस्ट अमित शाह यू कैन से. फाइन, हाईली एफिशिएंट बट गेटिंग इट. सो नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, यू हैव टू बी एफिशिएंट आल्सो. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट, Being capital intensive. The benefits of such. The benefits of such growth had long gestation period. And capital came from regional centers, from the metros. And therefore, reinvest kahan pe hua capital? Again, Mumbai and Kolkata. Delhi was not that important player during that time, remember. Mostly it came from Parsi community of Mumbai or Agrawal community of Kolkata, Marwadis of Kolkata. Fine? Fourth, a ancillary industries developed in this region. Ancillary industries developed in this region. But we are not linked to. We are not linked to local skill sets of handicraft or small scale industries. See, abhi we are focusing geographical information, geographical indication ka tag. We have khadi which is very well working. We are giving support to the handicraft industry. Tab to nahi tha, tab. It was the era of import substitution. Remembering? Indira Gandhi se pehle, it was an era of import. Fir 6-5 year plan mein, we decided ki now we will substitute our imports. Import substitution came in which scheme? 6-5 year plan. What do you mean by import substitution? Import substitution means whatever we are importing, we should try to manufacture it this time. Us time sab import tha. Isiliye, us time, if you remember, was the era of Daud. Once upon a time in Mumbai, once upon a time in Mumbai again. Port cities thi, smugglers were ruling. Understanding why smugglers were very powerful? Because everything was imported. We have to understand why underworld in India developed in the coastal areas only. Getting it? Ki employment dhundne ke liye Abu Azmi ko UP se Bombay jana pada. Because his skill set were required there. Dons ke. Fine? Import substitution. So what should have happened is, dekho, we don't have that much scope, but I hope you are understanding. Is point ka ye matlab hai ki tribal goods etc. were to be developed at the same time as the industrial goods, and fir demand should have been created, but we were not doing this. Fine? Therefore, village economy did not benefit. Village economy did not benefit. Next. As this industries required specialized skilled labor, local population could not get much employment. And hence, local population could not get much employment. Hence, trickle down effect did not happen. Just a minute. Hello. I'm in class. You will have to come at 5 o'clock. Trickle down effect did not happen. Getting it? Case study 2. And see, this area is out of question because geography. Geography is such that had this India been straight, the northeast India would have been very much developed. Tourism kaha bota, biodiversity kaha bota, Ayurvedic industries kaha bota, right? Digboy ke saath wrong ye hua, that is, Digboy could have developed as a growth pole or growth center had oil refinery not located in Mathura and Baroni. Oil was drilled here, refinery was drilled here, located here. That is why Ulfa came. Ulfa came with the idea that how can the natural resource of Assam help be transferred to the Hindi heartland region and help in the development of Baroni and Mathura. What? कौन सा दिमाग? किसको लगता है ये तो यू क्या किसको लगेगा ये फेल होगा? See, once you become an IAS, after 30 years, you will become a secretary and you will do this decision making. बीच में तुम पढ़ोगे कुछ? जो पढ़ना है वो अभी होगा IAS बनने के लिए. उसके बाद कुछ पढ़ाई नहीं होती. You will not even read Hindu. Your favorite paper will be Times of India. Do you think after becoming collector or this thing, members are going to spend the time on a paper which takes 2 hours? Yeah, on a paper which takes 10 minutes. And who likes to read Hindu? Why Hindu is 10 rupees? Because advertisement nahi hai. Kyunki circulation nahi hai. Understand? Except for South India. But phir bhi circulation theek hai wahan pe. In my engineering days, I used to read what? Bombay Times. Not even Times of India. Fine? Jaise Delhi Times hota hai. Ya midday. So, that is the reason. Ek rupay mein, do rupay mein. Getting it? And see, every decision looks good in hindsight. Tab to pata nahi hota. For example, take a case. Psychology mein 3 baar mains diya main. I should have worked one more year very hard on psychology, looking at ki haan maine ab tak geography ko bahut zyada time diya hai, but psycho ko kam time diya hai, isliye psycho mein shayad marks kam aa rahe honge. Nahi, maine socha hai, chalo doston ko pabad se clear ho raha hai, maine pabad le liya. Ab wo hindsight mein galat dikhta hai. Had I been successful with pabad, I would have given success to public administration. Fine? Every decision looks good in hindsight. Tab to pata nahi chalta what you are taking. What? Someone better? Fine, so you... Getting it? So, have you drawn this diagram? See, most of the decisions of India which have gone wrong is because we didn't have patience to go after that decisions. We flip-flopped. And historical reasons. Second FIR plan proper chal raha tha, toh China ka attack hua, Pakistan ke saath war hua. So we went into the planned holiday. Third FIR plan failed. Understanding? Historical reasons. Nobody could foresee China. Isliye good relationship with neighbors are so important. So that you can focus on what is inside. Yahan pe dhyan humara pura hai in protecting this border and protecting this border. How you can focus here? Inside. That is why USA and Canada are so close to each other. Australia and New Zealand are so close to each other. Getting it? So that they can focus in their development. See, koi bhi developed nations are always friendly with the neighbors. And koi bhi developing nations are not friendly with the neighbors. Kahan pe they are allies? Brazil and Argentina are not allies. India, China, Pakistan not allies. Competition for the market, ya fir colonial injustice, colonies, British policies. You don't read many books. If you read Grover and Grover, iski zarurat nahi hai. Grover and Grover mein kuch British jo viceroys the, unki policy thi ki let the territorial disputes remain. Otherwise, Asia, after we free them, Asia will be the economic powerhouse. So till the time we make them fight between themselves, they cannot be the economic powerhouse. Isliye to ye disputes unresolved karke gaye hai. Understanding? Yes, but dispute can be resolved, but people are not that much understanding. It is more becomes an emotional issue rather than a rational issue. Let China take Aksai Chin. Let Pakistan take POK. But fir emotions aa jayenge. You are not even concerned. You will never ever go to Kashmir in your life. But a person who is here may not even go here as a tourist, but usko akhand Bharat chahiye. Fine? So, ye problem hai. Case study 2. SEZs, the policy of SEZs. So, what is the definition of SEZ? Economics ho chuka hai? Padh ke. Kya karoge? SEZ one definition, yes, batao. Can I say special economic zones are the territories in which custom laws are? Or which are designed for certain economic purposes, so to give the competitive edge to a country in the terms of manufacturing, in the terms of services, kisi mein bhi hone do, so that to give the competitive edge to a country, it is designated as a customs territory. Customs territory means it is not considered as a territory of India, because the internal rules in India, they will not apply to this territory. And because of this, so for example, if India is a socialist country, license rajwala, यहाँ पे कोई license business की ज़रूरत नहीं है. Therefore, it is considered as a separate territory. Sovereign politically, it is a part of India, but economically, it is considered as a separate territory. Fine? अब understand this definition which I am giving, जो geographical definition है SEZ का. SEZs are the clusters of economic activities. Economic activities which are specially designed, SPATIALLY, specially, space wala, specially designed for supply side competitiveness और सप्लाई साइड कॉम्पिटिटिवनेस मेजर्स, सप्लाई साइड कॉम्पिटिटिवनेस मेजर्स. रीड द डेफिनेशन अगेन एंड टेल मी हैव यू अंडरस्टूड. स्पेशली डिजाइंड एक स्पेस में वी आर टेकिंग अ स्पेस, आइडेंटिफाइंग अ स्पेस एंड लुकिंग एट वेयर द प्रोडक्शन कॉस्ट इज गोइंग टू रिड्यूस. एंड बिकॉज द प्रोडक्शन कॉस्ट इज गोइंग टू रिड्यूस, जो सप्लाई है इट बिकम्स मोर कॉम्पिटेटिव. यू आर नॉट एज पर डिमांड साइड नहीं है, इट इज फॉर द सप्लाई साइड. फाइन. सो आयरन एंड स्टील इज रिक्वायर्ड, सो आयरन एंड स्टील विल मैन्युफैक्चर इन सच अ वे दैट इट बिकम्स वेरी चीप. सो एस इज एड. फाइन. इट जनरली मेक्स द यूज ऑफ agglomeration आ गया पेरोक्स एग्लोमरेशन कंट्री एंड इकोनॉमिक्स मेक्स द यूज ऑफ एग्लोमरेशन कॉमा सुपीरियर इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर and are not subjected to industrial policies of the government. India developed the SEZ model. With the twin objectives of one, export led growth and two, balanced regional development. The spread of SEZs in India is as shown in the diagram below. चेन्नई मैंगलोर 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 इंडस्ट्रियल ट्रायंगल मुंबई पुणे नासिक इंडस्ट्रियल ट्रायंगल दिल्ली पानीपत सोनीपत अमृतसर मोहाली इंडस्ट्रियल ट्रायंगल जामनगर अहमदाबाद सूरत इंडस्ट्रियल ट्रायंगल कोलकाता हुगली इंडस्ट्रियल रीजन एंड विशाखापट्टनम काकीनाडा इंडस्ट्रियल रीजन. But what are the problems of SEZ in India? Which state has the largest number of non-operational SEZs? UP. Non-operational. Pata hai data ya aise hi? Non-operational ya cancelled? UP has the number one non-operational SEZs. Second number pe kaun sa hai state which has the non-operational SEZ? Telangana. Fine? Can you see? SEZ should function as a growth pole. SEZs are there in India. But can you see these regions are the regions which are already developed? SEZs should have function as a growth pole agar ye blank regions mein aate. या हैदराबाद को डेवलप करते या नागपुर को डेवलप करते. फाइन, दिस इज नागपुर, दिस इज हैदराबाद, दिस इज भोपाल, दिस शुड हैव बीन डेवलप्ड. किसको ज्यादा डेवलपमेंट मिल रहा है? अहमदाबाद सूरत मुंबई पुणे नासिक दिस रीजन, कोलकाता दिस रीजन या दिस रीजन? वी वुड हैव सेड एसईजेड एज अ सक्सेस हैड दिस रीजन बीन डेवलप्ड, हैड दिस एसईजेड बिकम सो बिग कि इट वुड हैव टेकन regions here. Fine? Can someone tell me why not SEZ is not successful in India? They are composed mostly of service sector. So service sector is a footloose industry. Service sector industry can be based anywhere. It will never help in the regional development of that region, except ki thoda demand based, consumer based industries badhengi. But it will not help in creating employment in that region. Second, infrastructure problem. Third, thoda mujhe do teen hi point chahiye geography ka, because ye hai paper 2 hai hamara. Fine? But the biggest problem is SEZ is there for competitive in the export-based market. It is never for the interiors. ऐसे नहीं कि साबुन बनाया आपने SEZ में and then उसको इंडिया में बेचा. India is going to lose that because SEZ के goods के ऊपर you cannot charge GST. You cannot charge taxes. So you cannot sell that in India. The Indian government is going to lose the revenue. It should be to the outside world. For outside world, the SEZ should be near the ports. Where are SEZs in India? In the interiors. Secondly, even if it is in the interiors, there should be then fast development, fast communication. So there should be either a dedicated freight corridor or dedicated road corridor or dedicated industrial corridor. Dedicated freight corridor means the freight trains should go at a very fast pace. But what happens in India? Express train, if it is going getting late, तो फ्राइट ट्रेन को बाजू में किया जाता है एंड एक्सप्रेस ट्रेन इज अलाउड टू पास. हु इज गेटिंग मोर दिस थिंग? द पैसेंजर्स आर गेटिंग मोर इम्पोर्टेंस बट द गुड्स एंड सर्विसेज रिमेन बिहाइंड. पोर्ट्स आर नॉट वेरी वेल डेवलप्ड एंड कैन यू सी, ये मैंने जानबूझ के रेड कलर एंड ब्लू कलर बनाया. दिस टू इंडस्ट्रियल रीजन्स आर ज्वाइनिंग. आगे जाके क्या ज्वाइन होने वाला है? दिस रीजन विल बिकम द इंडस्ट्रियल हब क्योंकि डिस्टेंस कम है. क्या पीछे रह जाएगा? क्योंकि ये ऐसे एक्सपांड होगा और ये ज्वाइन होगा. सो दिस विल बी द इंडस्ट्रियल हब ऑफ इंडिया, वेस्टर्न इंडिया. पीछे रह जाएगा ईस्टर्न इंडिया. इट विल रिक्वायर गवर्नमेंट इंटरवेंशन, अदरवाइज ये रीजन पीछे रह जाएगा बिकॉज दिस इज नो लॉन्गर अ सिटी फॉर इन्वेस्टमेंट. फाइन. सो विशाखापट्टनम इतना ग्रो नहीं कर पाएगा बिकॉज यू कैन इजिली कनेक्ट इट विथ एक्सप्रेस वे. फाइन. सो गवर्नमेंट इज इट रियलाइजिंग उसका मिस्टेक? यस. Therefore, the answer lies in Bharatmala. And Sagarmala. Understanding why Bharatmala and Sagarmala? So that Sagarmala government is saying port-based industrial development, but port-based Q. Because our SEZ policy has failed. Therefore, Sagarmala is given importance. So that, let us use the SEZs again. Bharatmala, jab tak Bharatmala government kahega, it is for securing the border areas. But uska real reason is for the economic connectivity. And then, Delhi-Mumbai industrial corridor, Amritsar-Delhi-Kolkata industrial corridor, dedicated freight corridor. Ye sab kya hai? This will help in development of SEZ. Kya galti hui? Pehle होमवर्क करना चाहिए था एंड देन इम्प्लीमेंट. हम पहले इम्प्लीमेंट करते हैं एंड देन वी रियलाइज द मिस्टेक एंड देन वी डू द होमवर्क. अंडरस्टैंडिंग. एंड सी, यू कैन नॉट से इट इज अ मिस्टेक. इट इज, वी नीड ग्रोथ. इफ वी ट्राई टू डू होमवर्क इट विल टेक 20 इयर्स. कुछ होगा नहीं. सो जितना हो रहा है उतना होने दो. चलो ठीक है, रीजनल डिस्पैरिटीज है, होगा. ओवर द पीरियड ऑफ टाइम वी कैन करेक्ट इट, बट वी रिक्वायर नाउ फास्ट ग्रोथ. अंडरस्टैंडिंग. So SEZs in India, a failure reason is too much, but two important reason is no benefit. You can say no competitive benefit because of they are located in the interiors, and secondly, they are not connected, interconnected. Look at the साइज बीज एक्सेट्रा, तो वो तो है ही, बट कहां पे एसिजेड्स? इन चाइना. अंडरस्टैंडिंग. कोस्ट. वेयर आर एसिजेड्स इन इंडिया? इन द इंटीरियर्स. दिस इज अगेन एसिजेड. And इन सबको कनेक्ट करता है बुलेट ट्रेन. सो यहां से यहां तक बुलेट ट्रेन है. फाइन. 20 मिनट्स. पीपल स्टे इन दिस रीजन एंड गो टू वर्क इन दिस रीजन. शेंगयांग, चांगदांग एंड बीजिंग के वाला इंडस्ट्रियल रीजन. दिस बीजिंग इज द मेन टाउन हियर एंड दिस इज वॉट इज नोन एज मंचूरिया रीजन, द ग्रेटेस्ट आयरन एंड स्टील सेंटर ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. पिट्सबर्ग इज नो लॉन्गर द आयरन एंड स्टील कैपिटल. इट इज दिस ट्राइंगल, शेंटैंग, चांगजैंग एंड हार्बिन इंडस्ट्रियल ट्राइंगल. इसको कनेक्ट करता है विथ यांगटैंग. दिस इज द राइस ग्रोइंग रीजन ऑफ चाइना. इकोनॉमिक कैपिटल इज बीजिंग. फाइन. एंड ये सारा बुलेट ट्रेन से कनेक्टेड है. SEZs को दे हैव कनेक्टेड. अंडरस्टैंडिंग. दे हैव कनेक्टेड विद द हेल्प ऑफ SEZs. सो दैट इज व्हाई वी हैव लॉस्ट इन सम इयर्स व्हेन वी वेर कंफ्यूज्ड. इज ऑल बेस्ड ऑन SEZ. वुहान से शंघाई टेक्स 1 hour by bullet train. 1 hour. People start from Wuhan and come to Shanghai by 1 hour. 600-700 kilometers per hour ki speed. And properly, sab kuch hai usme. Wi-Fi se leke sab kuch hai wahan. Imagine Lucknow to Kolkata. Why will industries come? Where they will go? They will go to China. It is propelled by borrowing and it is totally export related growth model. Yes. Yes. दोनों है, देखो एक तो borrowing भी है and secondly export led growth model है. Export led growth model है इसलिए, see this is one SEZ in China, new economic zone. So export led growth model है इसलिए 2008 economic recession का उनको फर्क भी पड़ा. We could sail from that recession because ours is internal demand led growth model and theories of economic trade. हमें ट्रेड का ज्यादा फर्क नहीं पड़ेगा. Now what we should do is rather than getting confused and China ने ऐसे किया इसलिए ऐसे करना चाहिए, we have to choose कि do we want an export led growth model or do we want an internal led growth model. ऐसा नहीं कि export led ही होना चाहिए. Problem आता है policies का. Policies are not followed very properly. अगर internal led growth model नहीं होता इंडिया का, demand based growth model नहीं होता, then we would have got stuck after Pokhran. We could have got stuck after 2008 economic crisis, 2012 economic crisis. Hame farak padta when USA had put the sanctions on us. Hame in sab ka farak nahi padta because we know that ours is demand led growth model, internal demand. Export led growth model, government should very much focus. If China is doing in iron and steel, we should do in agriculture, agro based industries, textile based industries. Red color region is so successful, not because Modi was the prime minister, CM there. It is because it is export led growth model based on raw materials, oil refinery, oils, oil, and India is the largest exporter of refined oil in the world. We import the crude oil and we export the refined oil. So oil is refined, textile is exported and diamonds are exported. Fine? Diamonds are exported. Getting it? Polished diamonds are exported. India is the largest center for Amsterdam ke baad, we are the largest Antwerp ke baad, we are the largest center for export of the polished diamonds in the world. Getting it? Ye sab aap GS mein karte ho upar upar se. Ab understanding the linkages. Ye sab kiya hai ki nahi economics mein? Obviously itna detail mein nahi hoga. So problems, I'm just paper 2 may we'll do the problems, but you should know. Connectivity. Confused laws. Interior locations. Not based on local raw materials. Labor laws. I will not write labor laws in geography. I'll write no increases regional disparities. Regional disparities because rich regions ko hi fayda hua hai. SEZ. है ज्योग्राफी के आंसर में लिखने की जरूरत नहीं. ज्योग्राफिकल पॉइंट्स लिखो. पेपर 2 में डिटेल में लिखेंगे. केस स्टडी पेपर 1 में ये सब लिखने की जरूरत नहीं, इतनी जगह ही नहीं है. कनेक्टिविटी में इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर आएगा, फाइन। कंफ्यूज लॉज में दिस एंड दिस पॉइंट इज रिलेटेड, ये सब पेपर टू में डिटेल में आएगा। देयरफॉर सॉल्यूशन, भारतमाला एंड सागरमाला, इनफ है फॉर दिस थिंग। अब जनरल प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ द कंसेप्ट, प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ द कंसेप्ट, द कंसेप्ट, द कंसेप्ट became unpopular after 1980s, became unpopular after 1980s because Mishra identified four problems of this model. First, functional rigidity. Functional rigidity. बस ऐसे ऐसे करो ऐसे ऐसे होगा, जरूरी नहीं, that is what is known as functional rigidity. Fine. Second, who is Mishra? Mishra is the person who applied the growth pull to India. Fine. Second, incapable. This model is incapable of addressing. This model is incapable of addressing variations in the regional problems. Variations in the regional problems. Regional problems. For example, this theory is not successful. Mishra is favorite of UPSC. Paper 2 mein dekho hamesha question aata hai Mishra ji pe, fine. He is one of the biggest thinkers of India, Mishra. And to get marks in paper 2, now remember one trick. Put thinkers. Thinkers properly है paper 1 में, paper 2 में case studies बनाओ खुद के मन से, case study आपकी होगी, नाम आएगा मिश्रा, fine? As per the study of Mishra. कौन मिश्रा? You don't have to write in detail. RP मिश्रा और KY मिश्रा, just मिश्रा, fine? Second, दो तीन नाम आपको दूंगा, रामचंद्रन, नाम ऐसे लगना चाहिए कि कोई थिंकर हो, यू कैन नॉट राइट सनी सिंह एज पर द स्टडी ऑफ रामचंद्रन, नाम बी आर एक्सेट्रा, एंड दिस इज हाउ यू शुड टेक द मार्क्स, एंड दिस इज द ट्रिक, राइट। किसी भी पेपर में, नॉट जस्ट इन ज्योग्राफी, इवन इन सोशियोलॉजी, इतने सारे इंडियंस है, इवन द ज्योग्राफर्स डोंट नो कि ये होंगे कि नहीं, फाइन। बट नाम ऐसे चूज करो कि इफ समबडी गूगल्स इट तो ऐसे नाम आ जाए, रामचंद्रन नायर एट ऑल, फाइन। दुधाट एक ही थे, चीफ जस्टिस थे, बाकी देर हैज बीन नो दुधाट. फाइन, दुधाट देर नॉट देर इन. So this is that, don't use the name such as Kapoor's, fine, but yeah, so Mishra is very common. Psychology mein bhi yehi karte the, public administration mein bhi teacher yehi kahenge. So Mishra is so well known name, jaise that day he had told regarding whose name, 40 saal se wo naam chalte aa raha hai, but there is no thinker like that, understanding? So, but this I am giving you the real name, fine. The growth pole hypothesis does not apply to resource rich. This theory is inapplicable to resource rich. This theory is inapplicable to resource rich, comma populated, but socially and economically backward regions such as Bokaro, कोई भी एक नाम, जमशेदपुर लो, बोकारो लो, या विशाखापट्टनम, और हैदराबाद. Because as behavioral geography says, the mental image of the people should be changed. Mental image of the people should be changed for diffusion of growth. For diffusion of growth. Third problem, urban and industrial bias. Urban and industrial bias, fine. So this is biased for urban and industry. Jamshedpur is an exception. Why Jamshedpur is an exception? Bhilai itna aage nahi badh paya, Rourkela itna aage nahi badh paya, but Jamshedpur became very strong. Anyone from Jharkhand, Bihar? Why? Who is the company in Jamshedpur? Tata's. Who looked after Jamshedpur plant? Ratan Tata. If you look at his biography, he was studying in USA, right? Born and brought up in USA. At the age of 17 years, he was called by his grandmother, you have to come at any cost to India. He returns to India, stays for a day in Mumbai, and next day usko train se bheja jata hai to Jamshedpur. For next 4 years, he has to look into the regional development here. And Tatas don't tell the employees there ki he is a Tata. So he has to work at a ground level as a labor, then he rises as a manager, then he rises as a senior manager, and then after 4 years he is called to Tata office and said, tell us the problems of X level, Y level, Z level, and then it is implemented. Fine, ye Tata ka work culture hai. He Ratan Tata works as a laborer in this, isliye Jamshedpur is an exception, understanding? But baki ka it has all failed, because baki ka was ruled by bureaucrats. Fine? Means, I So in densely populated, it does not, it's a urban bias. Therefore, the hypothesis is inapplicable. Therefore, the hypothesis is inapplicable to culturally rich regions of North India. Full stop. Because these regions are agricultural powerhouses. Powerhouses. Locating agro-based industries in this region. Will not qualify for Peroxian definition of propulsive form. Peroxian definition of propulsive form. There has to be linkage between leading industry and the agriculture. Wo nahi hai. There has to linkage between the industry and the ancillary industries, but agriculture ke saath nahi hai. Is therefore, now someone had told me about Kanpur. Understand. Therefore, Kanpur, Hyderabad, etc. could not benefit. Fine. So unko kya leke aane padi? Refinery in Mathura. See, Assam was wrong in the sense, because when you decide at the center, you decide for the regional development of India. You cannot say ki Assam ka ye oil hai, so why you are sending it to UP or Bihar? Because at the center, no matter if your leadership starts like Raj Thackeray, ki on the son of soil, but if you come at the center, you will have to think on the pan India level. Getting it? So sabse zyada problems kahan the? Bimaru states mein. Not in Assam, not in Northeast. Northeast could have wait for till the time Bihar, Assam, etc. is well developed. That is the idea behind civil services. One state say, dusre state mein. So that national integration. Getting it? Therefore, Kanpur, Patna, Hyderabad, Hyderabad could develop only as isolated towns. With no trickle down effect. Kisne kaha tha trickle down effect nahi hoga? Midral ne. Fine? Cumulative causation theory ne. With no trickle down effect. Q? Because they all are located in the agricultural regions. And the last, functional rigidities. First, we have written functional rigidities. Then, last problem. Lack of spiltover mechanism. Spilt over mechanisms. Lack of spiltover mechanisms. That is, this theory does not explain how trickle down effect should be utilized. And how innovation should be used. Innovation should be used. for bringing regional development, for bringing regional development. Conclusion. Therefore, growth pole theory resulted in developing islands of prosperity and growth. Islands of prosperity and growth. But keeping an hierarchical order with poor surroundings. Poor surroundings. Fine? Understood the growth pole theory? Hierarchical order with the poor surroundings. Matlab, wohi centers develop hote gaye, baki walo ko fayda hua nahi hai. Fine? So I'll quickly revise. Kya kya hai problems? Problems hamesha yaad rakhna, quantitative hai, it does not take into cultural importance. Secondly, urban biased hai. Thirdly, batata nahi ki trickle down effect kaise hoga. Sirf kehta hai trickle down effect hoga. And fourthly, ki the propulsive firm wala idea itself is wrong because it is only for the industries. So it does not apply to the regions jahan pe social and economic backwardness hai. Fine. Now take one question. As it is direct question aayega. Explain how the concept of growth pole was modified. Growth pole was modified for Indian context by Mishra. Indian context by Mishra. Take this diagram. Understanding this diagram, large number of central villages. Central villages ke upar ek service center hona chahiye. Service center ke upar ek growth point hona chahiye. Growth point ke upar ek growth center hona chahiye. Growth center ke upar ek growth pole hona chahiye. This is what Mishra ka idea is, to make growth pole successful in India. have told you the chapter also, chapter 3, paper 2. ETAL, ETAL, ETAL. I'll quickly explain you, likhne ki zarurat nahi hai, fine. I'll share you on Telegram also today and I'll give you the printout also tomorrow, 3 pages. You will not find this in Khullar or any of the Indian, any of the books, because ye case studies hai. So he said ki there has to be central village. Now what is this central village? Central village is a village jisme 6,000 population hai. Ab India mein there cannot be a single village in which there will be 6,000 population. So it will be a collection of numerous villages in the region jahan pe population will be 6,000. Now in this 6,000 ka population of villages, he says that this should act as a service center, yeah, agricultural surplus of goods. Agriculture goods will be produced here. Agriculture based industry will be located here. Handicraft industry will be located here, which will go to a taluka region, which acts as a single service center. Quantitative theory hai, which does not talk about, Parakshan Bodivile is a quantitative theory which does not talk about social conditions. But Mishra kehta hai, and therefore in this central village for social conditions, one primary health center, PHC, should be established. Understanding what is the concept of PHC? Primary health center, jahan pe basic medical facilities milti hai. Plus there should be schools till 10th standard, yeah, at least till 8th standard. Aaj hota hai ki nahi gaon mein ye sab? Fine, Mishra gave his theory in 1974 and thus we changed. Therefore Mishra is so important. Mishra ka entire model has been applied in the Indian villages now. So PHC aa gayi and schools aa gaye. Then this service center or taluka will be region jahan pe the population is between 6,000 to 10,000 people, which will give higher education and what you can say, rural district hospital, rural hospital jisko RH kehte hai, rural hospital, fine, jahan pe thode better ilaj hote hai. Plus yahan pe schools are generally till 12th standard. Social ये भी कर रहा है. प्लस दिस विल सर्व एज अ मार्केटिंग सेंटर फॉर द गुड्स एंड सप्लाईज. मार्केटिंग सेंटर से हु विल टेक द मार्केटिंग सेंटर? जनरली अ एरिया विच इज ग्रेटर देन तालुका, सब डिवीजन, और इट कैन बी डिस्ट्रिक्ट, जहां पे मोस्ट ऑफ द एग्रीकल्चर गुड्स विल बी परचेस्ड एंड सोल्ड. दिस कैन बी APMCs. अंडरस्टैंडिंग APMCs. So because APMCs are there located here, people will go on that everyday basis to the APMC, and therefore it has to be a nearby area. Aisa nahi ki Rourkela yahan pe hai and the village is very far away and people have no connect with that. So they are going on the everyday basis, and this is like district headquarter, well, which will have schools, which will have colleges, and which will have agriculture market. Because of the agriculture market, secondary market will come in this region. It can be in the terms of tractor, automobile, or any of the market, yeah, textile market, etc. उसके बाद एक ग्रोथ सेंटर गवर्नमेंट ने फोकस करना चाहिए. दिस विल बी द मेजर टाउन इन दैट रीजन. सी फॉर एग्जांपल, गिव मी द नेम ऑफ डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स इन द वेस्टर्न यूपी, एक जो दिल्ली के एकदम आसपास है. सहारनपुर, मेरठ, बागपत, मथुरा, नोएडा छोड़ दो, नोएडा एनसीआर में कंसिडर, बुलंदशहर. सो सहारनपुर, बुलंदशहर, मेरठ एंड बागपत. सहारनपुर, बुलंदशहर, बागपत, मेरठ. मेरठ बिकम्स अ ग्रोथ सेंटर, वन सिटी इन दैट रीजन विच ग्रोज एट अ मोर पेस एंड विच विल हेल्प इन सपोर्टिंग द इंडस्ट्रीज ऑफ दिस रीजन इज अ ग्रोथ सेंटर. उसमें सिर्फ एग्रीकल्चर नहीं, उसमें सर्विस सेक्टर भी आएगा, उसमें इंडस्ट्रियल सेक्टर भी आएगा. अंडरस्टैंडिंग? एंड देन स्टेट कैपिटल. अंडरस्टैंडिंग? So this is what is the application of growth pole model in India, hierarchical, state capital, subdivisional capital. So you see how a panchayat, tehsildar, fine, subdivision magistrate, yeah, aajkal district magistrate, then divisional commissioner, and then state capital. So on the basis of administrative lines, he divided it in the terms of industrial lines. I'll take an example of Maharashtra. Mumbai, this can be Aurangabad, Nagpur, this can be Bid, Usmanabad, etc., small regions, this can be Usmiandar ke taluka, this can be villages. So he said, in India, if you apply it in this manner, then only there will be proper economic growth. Iska critical analysis nahi puchenge because yes, this is very right theory. Understanding? This is a completely right theory. Ab sirf iska problem hai implementation, nothing else. Because skill set development nahi hua na, usne kaha tha ki you should focus on handicraft industry. Handicraft industry. Understanding? Agricultural service center. Small scale village based industry. Wo nahi hua hai. UP ek state hona hi nahi chahiye sabse pehli baat. UP ke kam se kam चार पार्ट्स होने चाहिए या कम से कम तीन पार्ट होने चाहिए बिकॉज उसके बिना एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव इफिशियंसी आएगी नहीं बिकॉज अ पर्सन हु इज लोकेटेड नियर द बिहार बॉर्डर ही इज नॉट कनेक्टेड टू द कैपिटल ऑफ यूपी अंडरस्टैंडिंग सो देयर शुड बी स्मॉलर एंड देन देयर शुड बी मोर देन वन सर्विस सेंटर्स सो एक ग्रोथ पोल क्या है यूपी में लखनऊ फाइन कानपुर आगरा वाराणसी एक ही रीजन में है अलाहाबाद यू कैन नॉट से इज अ ग्रोथ पोल रायबरेली ऊपर यूपी सेंट्रल पॉइंट आगरा मथुरा और यू कैन से वाराणसी ईस्टर्न की तरफ वाराणसी देन अलाहाबाद देन गोरखपुर एंड अभी टूरिज्म के लिए अयोध्या मे बी फाइन एंड झांसी झांसी है बट हुआ नहीं है ना ग्रोथ पोल वेयर इट इज अ ग्रोथ पोल वेयर इज देयर इंडस्ट्री यस यही तो है इमोशनल कनेक्ट नोबडी थिंक्स रैशनली ऑन दिस लाइंस सेकंड प्रपोजल इज टू मेक चेन्नई मुंबई and Delhi UTs fine and government state government should focus instead of these three territories on the other regions Maharashtra nahi hone dega Chennai nahi hone dega Chennai going against a Hindi center you cannot imagine fine Actually, the concept is not of UT. The concept is to make them independent municipal corporations, not UT. UT is wrong word. Independent municipal corporations, just like London metropolitan region, just like New York metropolitan region. New York ka mayor hai, elected hai, and he is dependent on public. So this is what is there. Kab aaya tha ye proposal? Bahut pehle. Kab tha news mein? Pichle saal. So when these are independent municipal corporations, they have the power to issue bonds. How they will raise the money? Either on the budgetary support or either on the bonds, infrastructural bonds. Bombay mein, yes, Mumbai is issuing infrastructural bonds. Isiliye prelims mein pichle saal question tha. In India, the bonds can be issued only by the central government. Wrong. It can be issued by even the state or municipal corporations. Understanding kahan se questions aate hai prelims mein. So if your concepts are right and if you remember these concepts, तो फिर प्रिलिम्स बहुत आसान है गेटिंग इट इफ यू रिमेंबर दिस कॉन्सेप्ट्स वेरी प्रॉपरली प्रिलिम्स इज वेरी इजी इफ यू डोंट रिमेंबर द कॉन्सेप्ट्स प्रिलिम्स इज डिफिकल्ट कॉन्सेप्ट्स यू विल रिमेंबर ओनली इफ यू रिवाइज इट कुछ इतना बहुत पढ़ने की जरूरत नहीं है डेली पांच आंसर राइटिंग वो सब की जरूरत नहीं, कीप ऑन रिवाइजिंग द कॉन्सेप्ट्स। बहुत ज्यादा फैक्ट्स के पीछे भागोगे तो कंफ्यूज हो जाओगे। देयर आर पीपल हु क्लियर प्रीलिम्स इन 15 डेज, क्यों? दे नो द कंसेप्चुअल अंडरस्टैंडिंग, दे नो कहां से क्वेश्चंस आने हैं कहां से नहीं। देयर आर पीपल हु कीप ऑन वरिंग थ्रू देयर एंटायर प्रिपरेशन, विजन में से पढ़े या इनसाइट में से पढ़े या आईएएस बाबा में से पढ़े, फाइन, या कोई क्लास लगाए, कहीं से भी पढ़ो, आंसर वही है। थिंग्स गेटिंग इट? नाउ कमिंग टू द हार्टलैंड एंड रिमलैंड थियरी। हार्टलैंड बाय मैकिंडर। फर्स्ट आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू द थियरी, वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग थियरी, एंड देन यू टेल मी क्या होगा विद दिस। सो मैकिंडर डिवाइडेड रिमलैंड बाद में आया था, हार्टलैंड, रिमलैंड इज बाय स्पाइकमैन। हैव यू हर्ड द टर्म नेवल प्रिजनर? क्या कहता होगा द टर्म नेवल प्रिजनर? इम्प्रिजनमेंट बाय नेवी, कि नेवी उसको फर्स्ट आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू, यस दिस इज इट। Just take the diagram. हमारे इसमें एक ही डायग्राम है। Is it visible everywhere? So, Mackinder and Spikeman are two different things. Rimland is different concept from Heartland. Mackinder believes that power belongs to the land because maximum people live on the land, and as a result, resources, agriculture, सब कहाँ पे होता है? On the land. And therefore, powerful nation कौन होता है? जिसके पास ज़्यादा land है control में. Spikeman believes कि because Europe UK, for example, UK, Spikeman is from America. UK has controlled all over the world. It was become a colonial superpower, in spite of it being a very small nation. Means power is not on the land, power is in the oceans. Understanding? Heartland and Rimland theory, dono different hai. Ab kya hai? Present day relevance, you have to try to understand. Kyunki iske upar literature easily milta nahi hai. Especially in our topic such as geography. Pol science students can easily answer this, but geography students find it difficult to answer. So pehle samajh lo concepts. So coming to the heartland ka concept by the Mackinder. Mackinder divides the world into three eras. Pre-Columbian era, Columbus se pehle, Columbian era, colonial era, and after Columbian era. Right? Now he says this region of the world, that is North Africa ka region, Asia, Europe, South Asia, etc. This region is the one of the most continuous landmass in the world. Right? In which five people of the world live in this region. Or this is one of the most densely populated region of the world. And therefore, wo kehta hai, this region is the world island. What is this? World island. This region, jo hai, whether it is North America, whether it is the South America, whether it is Australia, are separated from this region. Ye pura continuous landmass hai. This continuous landmass yahan pe Sahara hai. It is not densely populated. Resources nahi hai, population bhi nahi hai, etc. This region is not considered because beech mein equatorial evergreen forest aata hai. Uske upar there is a Sahara. Understanding the map? And uske baad ek hi developed country hai, that is South Africa. So he does not take this into consideration. But he takes the regions to the north of Sahara, Asia, continuous landmass of Asia, Europe. This is what is known as the world island. Fine? Ab you consider the world island. If I consider this is the Himalayas, fine? Tian Shan, Kunlun Shan, Altun Shan, fold mountains of Russia, Japan ka fold mountains, Urals, these are the mountains, this is the desert, Arabian desert, Afghanistan, etc. And ye hai frozen. Right? So this and beech mein ka ye jo part hai Russia ka, if you know, Russia is steppe. So what is steppe? Is mountains ya plains? These are plains. And because these are plains, can I say this is grasslands, important for agriculture. So he says in this entire region of an heartland, the interior part of the heartland, which is there, the pivot area, in the entire part of the world island, he says the innermost part of Europe, that is Russia, is a heartland. Why heartland? Because it is a fort. Why it is a fort? How is the fort? Fort is inaccessible from all the sides except darwaze. Ek darwaza hota hai. That is the weakest point of the fort. But baki se inaccessible hai. So this is a natural fort, which is south mein there are Himalayas. Uske baad Gobi Desert of Mongolia. Ten Kunlun Shan, El Tian Shan. Yahan pe there are fold mountains. Baad mein Pacific Ocean hai. Fine. Yahan pe this entire part is frozen. So it cannot be, you cannot go. Yahan pe Afghanistan or the deserts of Syria, etc. You cannot go inside the fort. And this region is a vast plain region, vast grassland region, and therefore it is densely populated. It is a single country. Uske hisab se it is good, not densely populated. It is having good number of population, and because of the grassland, this is good for agriculture. Agriculture is food, and food is power, right? And therefore, this is the most powerful region of the world. Getting it? Jisko wo kehta hai as heartland. This red color is the heartland, and therefore kya likha hai? Land power. Fine? But is heartland mein agar jana hai, if you want to see, these are the geographers who belong to either US, the Spikeman, or UK, Mackinder. So they will always write from the Anglo-American point of view. So they say if you want to go into the heartland region, there is only one way, which is the weakest point of the fort, and that is Western Europe. Yahan pe ek chota mountain hai, Vosges Mountain. Block mountain. If you cross this mountain, you yahan pe andar jate hi, there is a vast plain area. Kuch nahi aayega beech mein. Fine? Sirf ek bar you Urals cross karke, if you go inside this mountain, or ye thode gap se, if you go inside this mountain, ye puri zameen aapki hai. You don't have to worry about the rivers, etc., or this region. And therefore, they say the way to the heartland is Germany. And therefore, Germany is powerful nation because it controls the road to the heartland. And isiliye Mackinder ki theory se inspire hoke Germany attacked Russia. Unko laga andar kuch bhi nahi hai. Fine? So he says during the pre-Columbian era, because this region was very vast, so the tribes, Mongols from the steppes, they could run over entire Europe and could capture the entire Europe. But with the coming up of the Columbian era, many regions became naval superpowers. And when they became naval superpowers, as this is entirely connected, the heartland ka fort was, so they are saying ki heartland ka ek hi rasta hai. Either you capture the heartland through here, ya heartland, because this land power does not have any access to the sea, isliye it is a naval prisoner. So the heartland will try to capture these regions. To avoid capturing these regions, matlab for avoiding Russia to expand its power, you should fortify these regions. And therefore, fortification was done with the help of navies. Understanding? And therefore, these regions are the naval superpowers. Naval superpowers. Came World War I, and with the World War I, Britain failed to enter Russia through Baltic Sea. Britain failed to, so second edition mein kya kehta hai, even the naval regions are powerful, heartland to powerful as naval regions are powerful. Dekho, pre-Columbian era mein kehta hai, this is powerful. With the development of the Columbian era, means navies, the power center has shifted here, and came World War I. World War I mein, Britain could not go inside from the Baltic Sea. Britain was not given access to Germany because Germany was against Britain, if you remember. And therefore, he modified his theory, saying that heartland is not this, heartland also includes this region. Ab jo lal color ka region hai, isme bhi ye heartland aa gaya, because Germany became the ally of Russia. And he came, see, I used to think that maybe navy is the powerful, but because Britain was not that much helpful, Britain could not capture Europe, that means rimland is not important, navy is not important, and heartland is very, very important. And therefore, again, the focus shifted on the heartland. And he gave the rule, one who controls the heartland controls the rimland, because yahan se aap expand kar sakte ho with the armies, etc. One who controls the rimland controls the world. Fine? Controls the world. Then he gave his second, third thesis in 1943, because by 1943, this became very, very powerful. Fine. In the third thesis, pre-Columbian era, World War I and 1943 ka thesis. In the 1943 ka thesis, he again said, it is the heartland which is the major center of the power, because pehle log ghode se chalte the, ab railway has come, and railway in the steppes can take people, resources, military from one part to another within few minutes or within few hours, or within few days, and therefore accessibility is there. Whatever will happen to the world, this region, agar aapne isko fort ke darwaze band kar diye, when if you capture each and every this part, phir bhi inko farak nahi padega, because they are agriculturally self-sufficient. They are having huge amount of resources. Yahan pe we have one of the world's largest resources of coal. Yahan pe we have one of the largest resources of iron ore. We have one of the largest resources of natural gas, even in this region. The only thing jahan se heartland ko explore nahi hone dena hai, you don't want heartland to expand, is through the Black Sea or the Crimean Sea region, because the Black Sea and the Crimean Sea is only threat to the Suez-Malacca Strait, Suez-Malacca Sea route. And therefore, USA started making friendly relations with this country, jisko kehte hai NATO. It came and captured Afghanistan, Taliban, it created Taliban, fine. It came and captured, it was having a very friendly relationship with Pakistan. It was having very friendly relationship with Japan. It came and captured Philippines. Two countries jo USA ke andar nahi aayi, wo hai India and China. Understanding the heartland theory. Ye dono country kiske saath thi? Russia ke saath. So USA could never make this entire blue region under its control through NATO. And to control NATO, Russia and China has SCO, Shanghai Cooperation Organization, SCO. Fine? So do you agree with this theory? SCO, Shanghai Cooperation Organization. Wo alag hai, wo thoda economic, wo abhi present relevance. So do you think this is powerful? Or do you think the blue area is more powerful? Or tell me, is this very right, even in the recent times? heartland ki those who controls the heartland controls the rimland, those who control the rimland rules the destiny of the world. Ye hai uska theory. Why? Why? Why you require sea to rule the world? That is what I am asking. तो export करो ही मत. So he is not talking about every country. He is talking about which country will be the superpower. उसके क्वेश्चन में है ही नहीं सिंगापुर, वो सब तो कंसिडर भी नहीं कर रहा है. देखो ये वाइट है, वो कह रहा है कि कौन किसको रूल करेगा. वेर विल बी द सेंटर ऑफ पावर, रशिया रेड रीजन या ब्लू रीजन. वैसे देखो टुडे द सेंटर ऑफ पावर इज नीदर दिस नीदर दिस, इट इज दिस. वाई? सबसे बड़ा स्ट्रेंथ क्या है हार्टलैंड का? इट इज इनएक्सेसिबल. फाइन, इट इज इनएक्सेसिबल. नीचे माउंटेन्स है, ब्लैक सी के पास. इसलिए तो रशिया यूक्रेन को क्यों डोमिनेट करना चाह रहा है? व्हाई इट इज टेकिंग क्रीमियन पेनिनसुला? पार्ट ऑफ रशिया. यस, टर्की वो सब छोटे पावर्स है. रशिया के सामने टर्की क्या है? सो टर्की को तो रशिया अपने साइड में ले लेगा. Fine. So he said, forget what you think about this. I was asking you. अब आई एम टेलिंग यू हार्टलैंड ही सेइंग इनएक्सेसिबल क्यों, क्योंकि उसको जाने के लिए रास्ता नहीं है. आज किसका ज़माना है? इंटरकॉन्टिनेंटल बैलिस्टिक मिसाइल्स. फाइन, किसका ज़माना है? एयर पावर, पावर का. डज इट मैटर टू सुखोई वेदर इट इज़ हिमालयाज, वेदर इट इज़ दिस थिंग, इट कैन जस्ट फ्लाई एट द हाइट. आज किसका ज़माना है? स्पेस वॉर का. सो इस सो दैट इज़ वाई द that is why Spikeman said no, Heartland is not inaccessible. क्योंकि सबसे पहले the Mackinder's idea of Heartland was very wrong. Mackinder ने कहा Heartland is a great plain वाला region, steppes वाला region. Wrong. Heartland में winters इतना strong है कि this is frozen by snow throughout the year. दो या तीन महीने ही it is without the snow. Secondly, Heartland इतना आसान नहीं है because the climate is too extreme. Thirdly, Heartland is not densely populated. Fourthly, because of the climate, Heartland is not utilized for each and every resources. And fourthly, due to the rise of capitalism, therefore capitalism has to survive. Because if there is capitalism, there is world trade. If there is world trade, then only there will be lack of Russia as a superpower. And fourthly, intercontinental ballistic missiles, etc. And therefore, Spikeman, if you remember Mahan, humne kiya tha. Therefore, Spikeman said that it is not the heartland. It is the entry to the heartland which can be controlled. Because this is densely populated, fertile. Densely populated, fertile. Fine? Plus, can be used for resources. And therefore, one who rules the rimland rules the world, not the heartland. Fine? Current affairs. With the melting of ice caps and glaciers, especially in the Arctic, ये दरवाजा खुल रहा है. किसके लिए दरवाजा खुल रहा है? रशिया के लिए. सो रशिया जो यहाँ पे चाहता था पोर्ट्स का एक्सेस, इट इज गोइंग टू गेट इट हियर. एंड देयर फोर ये थियरी टोटली चेंज हो जाएगी विद द मेल्टिंग ऑफ आइस कैप्स एंड ग्लेशियर्स. Why? Because the dominance of USA will be now challenged by Russia. And therefore, Russia has already started investing heavily in Russia already has 35 icebreakers with it. USA has only 2 icebreakers. So because heartland and rimland theory are going to change. But both the theories, aajkal ye nahi hai. So heartland is not important. What is important is rimland. So rimland jab important ho gaya, to heartland ka importance kam ho gaya. Heartland ko guard karne ke liye USA ko Pakistan ki zarurat hai. Rimland ko guard karne ke liye USA ko Pakistan ki zarurat nahi hai itni. Fine, because heartland के लिए दरवाजा था अफगानिस्तान. अफगानिस्तान के साथ अच्छा संबंध तो पाकिस्तान. So you see, rimland is important. So इसलिए USA ने पाकिस्तान को छोड़ दिया. And who is now best friend of India? So USA, India. Because right now it is the rimland theory which is going to be more important. Fine. I'll stop here. Tomorrow I'll take a long class. इसलिए because due to some unfortunate incident, मुझे उस लेक्चर हॉल में जाना है. बस यही थियरी है. हैव यू अंडरस्टूड? एक कहेगा वन हु रूल्स द हार्टलैंड रूल्स द वर्ल्ड, वो कहेगा नहीं, वन हु हैज द नेवल सुपर पावर विल रूल द रिमलैंड, एंड वन हु रूल्स द रिमलैंड विल रूल द